tame a skittish dragon spite, Sylvaneth must call upon the deepest notes of the spirit song, soothing the creatures with the emotion of their chorus. And in this video, we're going to show you how to take some elements of a Spiterider Lancer up to a parade-ready level. Now, as you can see here, we've already got a Spiterider Lancer painted up to a battle-ready standard. And if you'd like to see how we did this, you can check it out in a previous video. So we're going to start off by dry brushing a highlight of Hoeth Blue. So I'm going to take some Hoeth Blue here onto my paper towel and work off as much of that paint as possible, just leaving a small amount on the brush. Then I'm going to build that up on the model in thin layers. And with that dry brush done, we're now going to move on to some other details. So we're going to do some sponging next to get that green pattern on the tail using Moot Green. Then we'll be dry brushing the brown areas using Talon Sand and then highlighting up the wings using Blue Horror. So I'm going to take a small piece of sponge here and just get a little bit of paint onto it. Then, much like dry brushing, I'm going to work off as much of that paint as possible onto my palette paper. I only want to leave a small amount on. So keep working that off. Then I'm going to carefully sponge that onto the tail of the miniature to get that pattern. With that pattern done, we can now move on to dry brushing Talon Sand onto all of the brown areas. So that includes the bark, the claws, and the horns. With that done, we're going to move on to edge highlighting the wings using Blue Horror. Using a small layer brush for this, take your time, be as neat as you can. And with those wings highlighted, we're now going to move on to the next areas. So we're going to focus on the flesh, the weapon, and the shield. And we're going to highlight these using Blue Horror, then apply an edge and spot highlight of White Scar. So I'm going to take some Blue Horror back onto the palette and thin it down with some water. Then I'm going to roll my brush up to a point, and I'm going to use this on the raised areas of those lighter blue areas of the miniature. Now we're using White Scar as an edge highlight for those sharp edges. I'm using the edge of my brush for this. We're also going to use it as a spot highlight for places like the knuckles. With that done, we're now going to move on to some extra details. So for the eyes, we're going to highlight using Fire Dragon Bright, then dot them using White Scar. Then we'll pick out those leaves using Strachan Green. So I'm going to take some Fire Dragon Bright onto the palette. I only need a little bit, just to add a touch of water and make sure my brush is rolled up to a nice point. And I'm going to apply that onto the eyes of the dragon spite. Now we're going to dot the eye of the dragon spite using White Scar. Now we're going to use Strachan Green to pick out the edges of those leaves. And with that, we've taken some of our details on our Spiterider Lancer to a parade-ready level. By following this guide, you can easily transfer the techniques shown to any other models in your collection. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching, and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!